Entering atmosphere. LZ in sight.
Don't know what caused that fire, but let's be careful. Wonder if I'd get anything on the scanner.
Shield boosting!
Looks like we'll have to jump. Get over there.
So much violence.
Here they come! Got it.
Ah. What do we have here?
Varl, Ridge is yours, Pathfinder.
Ryder.
I thought I hated the Ket before. Then we learned about exaltation. I can't even begin to imagine how Jal feels about this.
Have anyone else here with you? Besides Cid?
No, just me and Cid. It's always been just the two of us.
No, I mean, someone special.
Special? Oh, you mean like... Oh. No, nothing like that. Who has time? What about you?
Like you said, who has time?
Eventually things will settle down a bit. Hopefully. Or we'll be dead. Anyway.
How did you hear of the Andromeda Initiative?
Short answer, Kesh. She was looking for some experimental ship mods, and I knew how to track them down. I thought it was a one-time deal, but she came back. Once, twice. Eventually, I figured out something was going on. Something big, with creds behind it. I asked, and she told me about the initiative. New galaxy, new home. Couldn't pass that up.
I was curious about you and Cid, being on your own from such a young age.
Yeah, I really wouldn't recommend it.
Where was your mother in all this?
Back on Palavan, I suppose. She was an awful person. All she cared about was climbing the ranks. She and my dad fought all the time. I think at the end they hated each other. When things were really tough, I thought about going back. But she wouldn't have accepted us. Whatever my dad did destroyed any chance of that.
Where was home? Palavan?
No, we'd already left Palavan by then. Whatever our dad was involved in meant we weren't welcome there. I hadn't even gone to boot camp yet. Cid was barely a year old. We eventually settled in a mining colony in the Minos Wasteland. 2 years later, our dad was gone.
How did you keep you and your sister afloat?
I was barely more than a kid myself, so lots of unskilled work, construction jobs. No one else would do the dangerous stuff, so I would, being up high, crawling under things. I could shoot a gun, so eventually I moved into smuggling. Even more dangerous, but lucrative. We were never rich, but we got to comfortable.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Ryder, you meet Spender yet? Colonial Affairs, the ass in Assistant Director. Got no idea why Addison keeps him around. Spender lied to the Krogan during the uprising, and he's headed out for Kesh ever since. He's up to something. I just can't prove it. We should pay him a visit on the Nexus.
What's it like to have Kesh as a granddaughter?
Kesh is my Rushan, child of my blood. Raised her myself. Damn proud of her, too. She did good, even with me for a granddad.
She's honest, definitely blunt.
She had to take after me in some ways, I guess.
Did Lexi brief you on Sam and squad connectivity yet?
Yeah. You want to hook that thing up to my comm, sure, but that's where it stops. Putting an AI in your head, giving it access to everything like that, it's begging for trouble.
Why do you say that?
I've seen what bots can do when they turn on their creators. Been in some of those fights. There's a reason that kind of research was outlawed.
Yeah. I was dismissed from the Alliance when news of what my dad was researching got out.
No shit. Ruined the Ryder name, I'll bet.
Almost. I'm not thrilled about it myself, but it is what it is.
Just make sure it can't unshackle itself. There'll be hell to pay if that happens.
I'd like to know more about you.
Fire away.
How did you and Vetra meet?
Huh, that's right. Your father brought you into the project pretty late, didn't he? Must have been a pretty steep learning curve since they thawed you out.
You could say that.
You make do with what you get. Anyway, I met Vetra back when we were building the Nexus. She swiped supplies I was trying to get for Kesh right under my nose. I tried to intimidate her into turning them over to me, and let me tell you, that Turian takes shit from no one.
I have no problems believing that.
Yeah, she told me off good. But here's the best part. She waited until I saw her again in Kesh's office, no less, to tell me she'd been working for Kesh all along. They're both still laughing at me over that.
Tell me more about the Krogan colony.
My clan's there. We also got some scouts looking for any unclaimed territory to grab up. Got a decent setup going. Self-sustainable, the works. Even some farming.
Farming? Krogan farm?
Food's food. Just because we can eat anything doesn't mean we gotta settle for scraps. I'm pretty fond of Corkrow roots myself. Takes a while to chew through those.
So, about all this combat experience you have, I'd love some details.
Ha! The list will be shorter if you ask me what experience I don't have. I've been doing this for a long time now. Centuries. Shit, well over 1,000 years. Don't even know how I'm still alive, to be honest.
Skill?
You need luck to be a merc. Skill, sure, but a whole lot of luck. And a really hard head.
Got any stories or advice to share?
Does a pie jack scratch its butt?
Anything about the Ket? Or combat in general?
Well, common Ket are pretty straightforward. Hit them hard enough, they die like anything else.
Tell me more about fighting Ket.
Wraiths are sneaky little shits, like to ghost up behind you when you least expect it. Just listen for them. They tend to give themselves away right before coming at you. Break through their head plates, then a headshot should do the trick.
Why did the Krogan leave the Nexus?
The Nexus got us Krogan to stop the mutiny. In return, we were supposed to get a say in station business. Spender, Addison's assistant, lied about the deal, and Tan came down hard. Too hard, so we left. Kesh is alone on that station now.
Do you think Kesh can handle station politics?
Kesh can handle anything. Thing is, Spender's a liar and a coward. He was part of the mutiny, I know he was. A lot of people got hurt because of him, on both sides.
So what's my part in this?
Things need to get sorted out, and my clan needs to get back on station, without Spender messing things up. Way I see it, you're probably the best one for that job.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
Hey, one last thing.
Yeah?
I don't love being called Kid.
I'll try to stop doing that. Can't promise I won't slip up, though.
Watch your tone. You saw what happened to Krogan.
This is amazing.
I don't know about these Angara.
Good morning.
Hi.
Or is it?
Your incompetence isn't my problem. Just do your job.
What do you want?
Whatever's going on, it's not fair to take it out on me.
Apologies, you're right. This is not your fault.
I haven't heard much good about that guy.
Whatever you've heard, it's not half as bad as the reality. Just last week, he tried to redirect some of the supplies we need to keep the stasis pods going.
Why?
I have no idea. But if Kesh hadn't stepped in and threatened to airlock him, it would have been a disaster. He's always like that. Making bad decisions, driving the Krogan away, treating people like scum when no one's watching.
You'd think your boss would have the power to do something.
She hates Spender, but there's only one of her. And she can't always be around to deal with him. Things have gotten so bad that Kesh had to literally kick him out of engineering.
How literal are we talking here?
Boot to ass. Oh, it was glorious. We need him gone, but as incompetent as Spender is at his job, he's insanely good at keeping it. Kesh can tell you more.
Del told me you saw her arguing with Spender. Pyjak's doing his best to throttle my department.
How's he getting away with that?
Spender doesn't know the first thing about engineering, but he knows how to play people. More importantly, he still talks to the exiles. I'm sure of it. I just can't prove it without your help.
Without proof, this will be hard to deal with.
Tell me about it. My grandfather tried to tell Tan. He wouldn't believe him without proof.
If he's really this bad, how does he keep his job?
Welcome to the Nexus. Look, I can work with everyday incompetence. But Spender's a traitor and a danger to this station. He needs to be dealt with.
This needs to be investigated.
I'm glad someone thinks so. Talk to Kandros. He likely has security footage, some kind of evidence. But you'll have to convince him to authorize release.
Nothing more for now.
Try not to die out there.
The extra resources from the colonies are really...
Species are at odds as talks break down over a unified curriculum for Initiative 2.
I'm sorry, Lana. They're just trying to boost our morale.
Firearm proficiency.
Thanks for understanding. About the outpost and the protesters.
You don't strike me as the political type.
I'm not. Just pro keeping everyone alive. Maybe those protesters will eventually understand too. It's done. I don't want to think about it. Need something else?
I was told I should talk to you about the mutiny.
I wasn't on the Nexus when it happened. I started reading up on it, but you know how things get around here.
Do you know where Spender was during that time?
Why Spender? Wait, you think he might have had something to do with the mutiny?
Maybe. Just trying to sort things out.
You know, the logs I did look through showed a few discrepancies. I meant to dig deeper. If you're investigating, how about I give you access to the security vid archives?
Thank you.
Anything else?
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
This file won't play. Sam, can you boost the quality?
Processing. Playback initiated.
Wait, is he handing something over to one of the mutineers?
Take this. It'll help you get to the armory. Don't.
I am sorry, Pathfinder. This backup file is corrupted. The audio tracks are heavily degraded. Someone may have deleted the original, and this version was restored during a system-wide reset.
Sounds like a cover-up to me.
I concur. While I cannot restore any more audio, the location appears to be Kadara.
How do you figure?
In common parlance, lip reading.
Good job. We're bound to find something there. Let's go confront him.
Apex personnel, please check your duty roster for important updates.
Mutiny went as well as you'd expect. Ryder, is it? William Spender. Apologies if we've met before. I meet a lot of people running Colonial Affairs.
Running Colonial Affairs? I thought you were the Assistant Director.
That's right. Assistant to Addison. So we know who does all the real work.
From what I've heard, your hands are pretty dirty. I saw the footage. You were handing something off?
What footage? From Gavorkum? Routine business meeting. Whoever you're talking to clearly has an axe to grind. And frankly, a Pathfinder shouldn't be wasting time on a witch hunt. You'd be wise to let this be.
Continue work to establish contact with our Milky Way descendants. As of now, Beacon... beacons confirming arrival in Helios remain unanswered. This is HNS.
Hello there.
I don't know. I don't know about these Angara.
I don't see it.
The use of firearms on the Nexus is against initiative regulations. The bar opens on the Nexus.
Ryder.
Ket genetics defies everything we know. They're bits of different species, and yet all Ket. It's bizarre, horrifying, fascinating, all at once.
Just think, while you're poking around in their genetics, they're probably doing the same with ours.
Huh. Wonderful. That's me never sleeping again.
I should get back to things.
Sounds good.